Alright guys and girls, welcome to another episode of Astral Auto Repairs. Can you dig it? Alright, part 13. 1977 Buick LeSabre, replacing the gaskets and a whole bunch of other stuff. So let's continue on and see what we can get done today. That's right, coming up on Astral Auto Repairs. This channel is a member of the Astral Stars, which means we have a zero-tolerance policy against the harassment of others. Anybody who violates that policy will be banned. For further information, please visit www.theastralstars.com. All right, guys, I can see today is already going to be a sucky day. Yeah, buddy. All right, check it out. I was getting ready to install the new oil dipstick. Got another one in here, but it just didn't fit right. So I wanted to get another one. And it goes between the exhaust manifold down there and into the port right there. But look at that mess right there. Dang it. So, you know what I gotta do, guys. I ain't gonna tell you. Alright, so what I'm going to do is turn the engine back to the side, remove this exhaust manifold, get the oil dipstick in, and put the exhaust manifold back. Alright, right back. Alright guys, got all the bolts out. Dang. That silicone really worked. Let me get a screwdriver here. Man, that thing was going to seal. Man, I got to clean all that up. Hey, there's my phone. Be right back. Alright. We're back. Let's get our new dipstick in there. Okay. Now, this thing has like a, you might well call it a crush collar. You see right there, that little lip that comes out of there? So what you gotta do is knock that in there. And then it'll seal right into place. But you don't want to do that until you have this lined up where it's supposed to be. So now that we got that in, the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead, clean this up, and we're going to put our exhaust manifold back up here. All right? Be right back. All right, guys, we got our oil dipstick in. Yeah, boy. Nice and tight. Great. Oh, still got the ear, but it's cool. It won't leak. All right, what's next? You know what, guys, what we're going to do next? Let's turn this engine back to its side. And while we got it out here, what I want to do is install the fuel pump. Oh, yeah, and the color. Guys, here we go. Bam. Gold. Yeah, buddy. Got these two brackets over here going to be gold. And over here, we got our pulleys that's going to be gold. Also, the air cleaner was chrome, but it was kind of rusty. So we're going to put some etching primer on that, paint that gold. We're going to try to get some stickers online that says Built by Astral. Yeah, boy. That's going to be cool. All right, let's get this turned back to the side and get this done. We'll be right back. All right, guys, set this fuel pump in. What the heck? All right, yeah. Got to make sure it goes around here into, you know what I might do, guys, I'm going to take off this line going to the, what goes to the carburetor, I'm going to take that off, and I got to make sure that goes up under that, over that eccentric that operates the fuel pump. And we got a new gasket with some silicone on both sides, so let's take care of that. Be right back. All right, guys, there we go, we got the fuel pump on. And I put the fuel line into place, but I didn't tighten it up yet. All right, this is ready. You know what? Before we do that, one more thing. Let's take this off and show you guys what we got to go up here. Be right back. Oh, okay. All right, guys, what we got here is our plate to eliminate our EGR valve. All
got the gasket and all. Look at that, man. That thing gonna sit just like that.
Why you replaced the eliminator?
Because it's no need for it. You know, this thing don't need no.
So why did it come with one?
Emissions. But that was back then. This is now. Yeah, buddy. Okay?
Okay.
Now, hopefully. Don't make me have to use the other bolts, man. Dang it. You know, this is bogus, man. I'm gonna have to. The same size. Well, hey, that's what you get. So we'll probably have to use the old bolts, which is gonna suck. I like that chrome thing to it. Yeah, it'll hold down there. Good. All right, so let's get this on, and we'll be right back. All right, guys, we got our plate on. Look at that, man. That looks nice and shiny. Also, what's good about this is, if you ever have to do the valve cover gaskets, the EGR valve always went over right around here. So you had to remove the EGR valve to get the gasket off. So now you never have to worry about that again. All right, this engine is about set to go in. The next thing we're going to do is, over here, we got the transmission. I showed them the color, gold. Yeah, buddy. Sylvia made me get that color.
No, I
didn't. Alright, here's the transmission.
I would have picked purple.
Alright, now what we're going to do here is, I want to change this gasket before we mount it up to the engine. But what I'm going to do is, maybe I'll hook the chain up to it or something, use a hoist, and put a pan up under it so it can drain the rest of the fluid out. Turn it over and do what we gotta do. All right, we'll be right back. All right, guys, got my transmission turned upside down. And what I'm gonna do here is clean this up, change this gasket, and change the filter inside. We have already changed this, but heck, I got it out like this. Might as well change it now. So, let's get this off, and we'll be right back. All right, let's get our cover off. A little magnet got squished a little bit here. We're gonna bang this pan out. Make it more even. And there's our filter. All right, so let's get us a new kit. Get this off of here. Let's get us a new kit. Change this filter, put the cans gasket back on, and what we're gonna do is mount this to the engine, and we're gonna install it. Install everything. All right, we'll be right back. All right, guys, we got our new gasket set. Next thing I'm gonna do is go around here and wipe this off. Give me a little pick and pick out that little stuff this inside there, and let's take off this filter. Okay, the next one I'm going to do, guys, I don't know if you can see that pan, but it's like all beat there. Heck, I'm going to remove these magnets inside of here, clean them up, and take a block of wood and beat this pan back flat. All right, let's get that done. We'll be right back. All right, guys, we got a new filter on. Now I'm going to go over here, and here's the pan. I'm gonna set out magnets in there. I'm setting the magnets away from where the filter is gonna set at. Now, we got our gasket here. I lined it up. So let's get this lined up. Perfect. And then we're gonna take our bolts and we're gonna put them through the gasket like that, and it holds the gasket up like that. And with this kind of gasket, you're not supposed to use any kind of sealer or silicone. So let's get all our bolts in and we'll be right back. Alright guys, we got all of them in now. Let's put, now guys, in case you don't know, those magnets, any kind of shavings and all, will get down there and the magnets will pick it up instead of letting it circulate through the transmission. Alright, let's get our bolts and everything lined up. Put them all in. Make sure I start them. It's like I always tell you guys, start on my hand first. So that way you know they're they're not cross-threaded. Then take my little quarter-inch drive ratchet. My half inch. And I'm gonna go and tighten these up. And these are not super tight because you can crush the gasket. So you just bring them down till it stops, and then you keep going around, and then you snug them up a little bit more. Alright, let's get that done. We'll be right back. Alright guys, we are looking good, man. I'm liking this job. Alright, the next thing I'm gonna do is we'll go get my transmission jack, turn this over, set this on the transmission jack, and over there, you can see our converter, torque converter. We're gonna set that converter in, and what we're gonna do is, let's see here. Let's go turn around here. We're gonna take our engine's hoist, hook this, put the chain up on the engine, pick it up, and so we can mount the flywheel on, and we're gonna get that transmission mounted up there. Be right back. Alright guys, there's our transmission jack. Transmission turn over. Still got fluid coming out here. Dang it. There we go. Set that into place. And looks like, where's the other? Tilt this thing upward this way. I like this transmission jack, man. I'm glad I got it. Got this from Harbor Freight years ago. This thing is cool. Whoops. Tilted the wrong way. Now it's supposed to get a, how supposed to have a chain hooked up to it and going around so it don't fall off. But I think we're good. Alright, let me take my gloves off. And the next thing I'm gonna do here is put the chain on the engine so we can, and I gotta turn it around and pick that up. Alright, be right back. Alright guys, you see, got it up on the hoist, got it picked up and all. Now, get that off of there, get the engine stand out of the way. Now let's unbolt the rest of the engine stand. And let's go get our flywheel. Alright guys, we got our flywheel. Let's get this flywheel. Get these bolts started. That's a big weight on this flywheel. Alright, let's get this flywheel on and get it bolted up. Be right back. Alright guys, we got the flywheel bolted on. Alright, now we're going to take our transmission before we put our converter in. And we're going to roll our transmission over here. Then we're going to put the converter in. Then we're going to bring this up and mount it in. So, let's... Yeah, that's a good look. We're all good. Yeah, buddy. Oh, look at that. Oh, man, I'm good at this mess. I don't like this. Let's get our converter, get set up in a different position. We'll be right back. Wipe my hands off before I hit the stop button. So we yell at me. All right, there you go, guys. You're looking at it right there. This transmission look kind of crooked. So, and it's a little straight. Setting the converter in kind of sucks sometimes because you got to push it on and then you got to spin it to make sure it slides into the pump. Dang it. There it is. There it is. I think I just felt it go in. I mean, you always got to make sure. Dang it. Step on this thing. Yeah, that's set in. That's set in. Let's take our converter bolts out of here. Put this downshift cable. Alright, now what we're gonna do, we're gonna bring the engine down enough so we can bring our transmission forward. I think you hopefully got a good look there on that. Okay, tell me when to stop. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here, if I can find my jack handle. I'm going to, looks like I got to twist the transmission a little bit. This is what I get for having this thing. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's go over here. See, I like doing this much better outside. Alright, let's go get us some bell housing bolts. And we're gonna put this in. I think I'm gonna leave the dipstick out. Make sure I can get to it. Make sure this thing goes in without anything interfering. I think the dipstick had a problem when it was coming out. I think it was interfering with something. Alright, let me get the bell housing bolts and I'll be right back. Alright guys, let's get our bolts in here. And we got some, I wasn't too happy with the other bolts. So we got some new bolts. Ain't no use in half-stepping now. And we got this one over here. That's for the oil dipstick. And then what I'll do is I'll put the bolt in there, just in case. Now let's get our 9/16. We are good to go. We are ready. And I'm going to leave this like this to keep tension off that chain and all. So I'm going to leave the jack on until we're just about ready to put it in. Which is not too far. This is definitely looks like we're going to be setting this in the next episode. I am digging this. Get out. Dipstick up there. Oh, and then before we do that, we're going to put our transmission lines on while it's out here. That's going to be a lot easier too. Because over this way, our transmission lines hook up right there, and then they come along here, and there's a bracket we gotta take off one of the oil pan bolts. Then they come up, might as well have that on too, right? I mean, I'll wait till we get in there. And we gotta put our converter bolts in. So actually, well, that's gonna be in the next episode. And once we put our converter bolts in, okay, I take out these spark plugs, put the new spark plugs in while it's out here. All right, we'll be right back. Alright guys and girls, there you have it. That's the end of part 253. It seems that long, man. But we're definitely coming to a, these mosquitoes are biting me, man. Definitely coming to a close on this. Alright, if you have any kind of comments or questions, be sure to put them in the comment section below. Or you can email me to Tim@AstroAutoRepairs.com. Oh man, this is turning out to be good. Alright, this is Timmy from Astro Auto Repairs. If we can't repair it, nobody can. I'll see you next time.